Hi, I'm Sandy Babb. Welcome to my studio. I have a project share for today. This is my submission for the Shabbydabbydoodah design team from Tina in the UK. And she did a call for design team members to send in submissions using one of her kits to make something. So this is my submission for that, and I used two kits in this project. I used the complete Vintage Birds theme kit that consists of cards, envelopes, tickets, and tags, and I also used a few pieces from her watches and clocks vintage fussy cuts. Just for a few little fillers. And my project is a folio. Decided to do a folio. I haven't done one of these in a long time. And I ended up with a little bonus because this was supposed to go inside and it was getting too bulky. So we ended up with a little extra thing here. So what I used in this project, I used a couple of file folders to make my folio. And they were center oriented, meaning that this portion here was in the center. The base design of this folio was inspired by Rosa Kelly. This is her original design here, what you get once you make your folio up. And then from there, I took off and did my own thing and did a little modification on it. But it's basically one file folder that is scored here and here, and I will leave the link to this tutorial below so that you know, if you want to make the folio, you know, like roses. This is a portion that flips up and it flips down. Once you get it sealed, you will get a pocket here, a pocket here, and a pocket here. And then you use portions of the other folder to cut tags that go in your pocket. Okay, and I modified this design just a little bit. Now, I didn't use any specific papers for this because I'm trying to use my stash up. So what I basically used, I just went through my stash. I used a bit of some collage paper that I had already had made. A little bit of flocked paper. This is really old. I got this on, well, I thought it might have the label. I got this on clearance at Hobby Lobby a while back. I used some vintage lined papers, the blue lined, and then this little brown paper. I used some of this green ledger, dictionary paper, and this is vintage wallpaper from, gosh, I think it's from the 60s. Some pieces of vintage wallpaper, craft card, handmade paper. This was a cover from a sheet music, the back of it, and I like the color of it. A little bit of cardstock. Let's see, there's some more cardstock. Those two cardstocks. A piece of scrapbook paper. This did come from a kit. I can't remember the name of it, though. And then some hand-painted tracing paper. So those were my papers I used. I also used some hull reinforcers, which I inked and stamped. They're just white when you buy them, to, you know, do some reinforcing. I used some green sari silk. This is from an old embroidered sari. Some cording hemp, some chocolate colored hemp. I used the Ranger Potting Soil Archival Ink and an applicator and three stamps. I used this. This is a really old stamp. It's French script stamping up. Got this years ago at Hobby Lobby. This is Recollections. It's a little chickadee. And then this was this little tiny bird came here with a, I think it was Making Memories set. It's really, really old. So that was basically, besides my adhesives, which I used a glue stick and a couple of different glues. And that's basically all I used on this project. So let's dive in and look at her. This folio measures 9 inches tall, 4.5 inches wide by 1/2 inch deep. So what I did was to stitch when I, let me get my other little sample out here. When I put this together, I ran this seam to seal it through my sewing machine with a decorative stitch with brown thread to get this little vine pattern. And then to seal this edge, I just zigzagged straight down it. Now you can glue it. You don't have to do the sewing machine. I just knew that this was going to be the outside and I just wanted a more decorative element. So I have placed vintage wallpaper here and here. This comes in the kit. Isn't that darling? Look at that little round tag. This comes as a kit and I have used this as part of my closure. And I've got just sari silk tying it. Now I did an addition onto my folio where I have another pocket, a couple of extra pockets and things. So I'll just show you those as we go along. I've got this portion of it glued down right here so that this just kind of unties and flips open. On the inside, you can see I've used a little bit of the dictionary page and a piece of the border from the wallpaper. And when you open it up, you have a whole little world of what I like to call, my phrase that I've kind of coined for this is more like a jot journal. And that means there are small places to jot things down. This is not going to be a full-on, you know, blank, you know, journal that you're going to write in. This is going to be where you're going to keep, you know, little things. And one of the things I thought would be great to do with this particular project, if you're doing a decorating project, this would be amazing to make this and stick little paint samples in or photos of your rooms, measurements to keep everything together. Tape little fabric samples, you know, to some of the cards or something. And it would be a great little tool to take, like, you know, when you're doing a decorating project. Okay, so let's dive in. On both sides here, I have covered the inside with some vintage wallpaper. I've used a little piece of the folder that was left, stamped it, stitched it, and then just glued it down on both sides for a tuck. On one side, I have some of the little brown paper that's just been stamped with the little chickadee. Here's one of Tina's little cute images. Let me come in so you can see that. Look at that little bird. Isn't he adorable? It's just a little card that folds open that you can write on. And those things I just have tucked right here in the front where you can jot your little notes down. On the other side, I have a couple of more of the tags from the kit, from the bird kit. And another piece, this is just on green ledger, and I'll just stamp the little chickadee. And these are just tucked in the other side, just in the little flap here. On the front, we have a little pocket, and all this, well, except for this is a vintage stamp that my friend Dorothy sent me from the Netherlands. She sent me a bunch of little stamps several years ago. It was a fun little thing. And so this is all these little parts and pieces are from Tina's kits. The postcard comes from the bird kit. All of this is from the bird kit. Now this piece and the little butterfly and this ticket come from the watch and clock kit. This is a, let me widen it just a tad. Well, let's see. Try to get y'all stay, you know, really in focus. Okay, so I've just glued this down like a pocket. On the inside of this flap here, glued down scrapbook paper. You can see that there's a scrapbook paper background. And inside there, that's casting a shadow. Inside there, you can see the background. Here's the little pocket, one of the little butterflies. I've used a portion of one of the postcards because some of these I altered slightly. And so I had a little piece left, so I just over stamped it and glued it to some paper and cut it in a little tag shape. This is one of her postcards, and I have covered the back with some of the brown lined paper. Here's one of the little envelopes. This, I just cut a circle of the paper and stamped it, and the little envelope opens, and it just has a little fold out of parchment paper that you can write on. And I lined the envelope with the brown paper. You can see that there's a liner there. And these are always fussy to get back in there. And those just tuck in the little pocket. This is a tiny little tuck pocket. And inside it has a little tiny piece of ephemera. And yes, it's got, you know, a place you can write. But you could just tuck some little tiny note. How about a fortune from a fortune cookie? That would be a good thing to tuck in there. It's tiny. So, this is on a magnet, this piece here. You can see that I've got that on a hidden magnet so that it flips down. And when it flips down, I'm going to show you the whole thing, but let's start at the top and we'll go down. When it flips down, you've got this little area here that I covered with some vintage wallpaper, some ledger paper, some of the craft card, some cardstock, and cut pocket slits. Used some of the ephemera from the bird kit. These are tags that come with the kit, and I covered those with paper. They go into the slots. Added a little bird ticket. Now her tickets, some of the tickets have a little colored border on the outside, and I did cut that off, and the reason I did was because it didn't coordinate with my journal as well as I would have liked it to, and I love the images, so I just inked, you know, the edges. So these little tags slip here. Now this is also glued in as a pocket, so there is a pocket back there. I don't have anything in it, but there is a pocket, and these will not slide through. I have a little, this will go, that's as far as that'll go. This one will only go this far. You know, those, they won't slide through. You're not going to lose things in there. There is a backing on there. For the bottom piece, let me slide this up. For the bottom piece, there is wallpaper. I mean, well, there is wallpaper, but then there's scrapbook paper. This is from the Watches and Clocks kit. This is a little pad of paper. And underneath, let me see if I can turn it sideways where you can see. This pad is removable. If you were to use it, you could punch paper and tie it in here. So my string is glued under another image from the watch and clock thing. So you could actually untie this, take the paper off, and replace it if you were to use all of it. Kind of turn the kit a little sideways so you can see the whole thing laid out, because it's kind of long. And my desk is not very deep, so I can't really, you know, show it to you the right orientation. But that's that. Okay? So that snaps closed, and then this flips up. And when it flips up, I've covered this with handmade paper. These are images all from the bird kit. These are, this is hand-painted tracing paper that I made little envelopes out of. And inside each little envelope is a little parchment paper that you can write on. So there's those. You have to excuse me. It's getting to be springtime here, and it's allergy season, and I'm a little scratchy throat. This unties, and it is a flip out. It's got the postcard on the front, and you have a little peekaboo kind of fun images on the back. So you can write on this on both sides. It's blank all the way. And that just ties down. So there's lots of little fun interaction with this little folio. I thought it was a really clever design. Down here, let's see. Lean that up a little bit. Down here we have the middle of the inside, and there is a little notebook in the middle. This is covered with vintage wallpaper. This just has a little tuck here using some of the wallpaper border. This is an envelope. I don't know if you can see. It's kind of an old envelope that's been collaged. This was inspired by, I believe it was Roxy Creations. I'll look it up and I'll leave the link to this window envelope thing. I thought it was really clever. So I just used various pieces of every paper that I had and used a little collage. There's one of Tina's images, and inside is covered with the sheet music book, and it just has a little pad of paper. Now this is just tied in, so if you were to use the paper, you could just cut more paper and replace it, so it's not permanently bound. This is meant to be used, and then, you know, you stick more papers in it. So there's the little notebook, and the notebook measures, let's see, I don't know what it measures, I didn't check. It's like 7 1/4 by about 3 1/4, somewhere around in there. Not quite 3 1/2, and not quite 3 1/4, kind of in betweenish. Getting little paper scraps in there. So that's that. I've added a little bit of the hemp and some little beading, some wood and bone beads, some little metal beads, just to make a cute little notebook. That flips back down. Now, behind this is a pocket. And when it pulls out, and this one also, and this one also, right behind this, there's a pocket. So I've done one of Tina's postcards, just inked it and stamped it, put some lined paper where you can write on it. I've stamped in here, so there is a place for a little postcard. I'm getting little scraps everywhere for that little postcard in there. These are also, this was one large image that was in the kit, and I cut it apart and rounded the corners, and this is one of the images from the kit. And made these large tags. The back of them just have the green ledger paper on them, and I made a tab so that they were easy to pull out. That's another writing space, so that goes in there, that goes back in there. Then we have two more pockets. So in between this pocket, there is another tag in here. Let me see if I can get it out. Oh, I'm pulling the hole. This is a little tight. I might need to cut that down. Oh, there it comes. There it comes. This was one of the envelopes and postcards. Now, you're going to notice, let's see, I'm trying to find one that was in the same sort of tone. I don't see one. Well, you'll notice that the tone of her postcards were a little more in the tan vein. Well, there were a couple of, I believe it was two postcards in an envelope that had a lot more vivid blue. It was more of that, of a really bright blue. So what I did on this is I overpainted this design. And I'll leave a link to a tutorial that I have on my YouTube channel for overpainting papers. And what I did was just take some paint to make this blend, because the blue was so vivid. It was a beautiful blue, but it was so vivid, it just didn't coordinate with the kit, and I wanted to use everything in the kit. So what I did was just overpaint it. I glued it on top of a piece of the file folder. Some of the paper and some, this is not washi tape. I was looking for washi tape and I didn't have any. This is actually florist tape, and I just glued it down, and then when it was done, I went over it with a little matte medium, because florist tape is sticky. You know, it's meant to be stretched into stick, but it made a really crinkly, cool, kind of sheer tape. So that was fun. So, that tag goes in the middle pocket. Then when you flip over to the back, there is an extra pocket on the back. I had an extra piece of file folder, and I thought, well, why don't I just put a pocket on the back too? So I did two of these. So there are two of these that you can write on, and they just slide. Let's see, This one's a little bigger, so it goes in here. They just slide right down in there. And you have your entire little folio there with all these little places to write and keep little mementos or little notes. You could take out all the writing things and put little keepsakes in there. You know, anything like that. Now, this was supposed to be in there, but it started getting a little too chunky, so I was like, I gotta quit. So this is just an extra little thing. It is the flocked paper that I used one of Tina's images in some of the wallpaper and craft card to make a little front, and it's just simply a little book, just a little notebook. But this one you could just slip in your purse, you know, to go with it. Wrap it, pull that through, and call it a day. So I hope you've enjoyed this little submission, and I hope you all have a great week, and I will see you back in the studio with another project. So thanks for visiting.